Hey everybody, this is Jason Akers again with Green Acres Pest Control. And today, I want to talk about travel and hotels and how to avoid bed bugs when you travel. This is a question that comes up on my channel almost every day. If you enjoy the video, if it helps you in any way, think about giving me a thumbs up. Think about subscribing to my channel. It really does help a lot. And I'm on, you know, all your different social medias. I'm on, you know, Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, you know, all kinds of places you can find me. Links are in the description below. But if you, like I said, if you really like it, the thing that helps me the most is just share it around and thumb up my video and subscribe to my channel so you can catch my live streams. I do live streams every Thursdays. Try to release a video every Tuesday. So let's get into talking about why people get bed bugs from hotels. What causes bed bugs to be a problem? And hopefully you can avoid getting bed bugs when you go out of town when you vacation. So, what hotel gets bed bugs the worst? This is the golden question. This is a question I get asked all the time. All right, so I'm gonna explain a little bit about hotels. I want to explain why hotels get bed bugs. All right, let's start with that first, and then we'll go into how you can avoid getting bed bugs from hotels. So hotels get bed bugs because people travel to hotels. So the way you get bed bugs, the only way to get bed bugs in today's world is you have to bring them in from other places. So if you have friends, family, relatives come and visit you, a lot of times they'll have bed bugs. If they have them at home, they have them on their clothing. And so when they come and they visit and they sit down on your couch or they sleep in your bed overnight or something like that, the bed bugs will crawl out of their luggage or they'll crawl off of their person and they'll be in your house. So that is a way that people get bed bugs. It's a very common way that people get bed bugs. In fact, in 2019, it was the number one way that bed bugs were being spread. They were being spread from person to person. They weren't really being spread from hotels as much. I mean, people were still getting bed bugs from hotels, but they weren't getting them to the volume as they used to, you know, back 20, 30 years ago. Back when I first started killing bed bugs, the number one way people were bringing bed bugs into their home was from hotels. Now it's from other friends and family and relatives, people bringing them in to their house that way. So how can you avoid this problem when you're traveling? So let's talk about hotels. So you're going to go out of town. You're going to visit some friends and family. Maybe you're going to Thanksgiving. Maybe you're going to stay overnight somewhere. How do you pick your hotel to avoid bed bugs? So this is going without saying. This is why people say this. This is common knowledge amongst most people with bed bug problems. Cheap hotels are a bed bug cesspool. Why is that? All right. Can you really save money on a hotel and not bring bed bugs in your house? So I do long distance bed bug services in Virginia. I travel all over the state of Virginia. I live in Lynchburg, Virginia. So when I travel from Lynchburg, Virginia to say Arlington or Bristol or Front Royal, Winchester area, I travel. And it's sometimes 3.5 to 4 hours one way. So I usually will go, I'll travel up, I'll do the job, and then I'll travel back the next day. So this means I'm gonna need to get a room overnight. Where do I stay? How do I eliminate I've never brought bed bugs home from a hotel, ever. But I have found bed bugs in hotels. Which hotels have I found them in? So when I travel to Northern Virginia, Northern Virginia is a very high infested area of bed bugs, like around the Washington, D.C. area of Virginia is pretty heavily infested. It's also pretty heavily, a lot of people live there. You know, there's a whole lot of people in the D.C. metro area. The cost of living is extremely high, and people are living in very small apartments just to be able to get back and forth to work because they need to live near the metro and need to travel around to get to work. So when I go up there and do my bed bug work, because of the high concentration of people, bed bugs are worse. you know, there are things that spread in cities. Bed bugs, diseases, and stuff like that spread really easy in high concentrated areas where a lot of people live. And so the hotel chains do get bed bugs because there's a lot of people that travel in and out of the DC area. And so DC made the top 10 list of worst infested bed bug cities in the United States last year. I think they were like number 3 of the most infested places in 2019. So it's very highly infested area. How do I avoid bed bugs when I go to hotels? So the reason cheap hotels get bed bugs is because the people that can't afford to stay at a higher end hotel typically can't afford a lot of things. So these people usually will get used furniture off the side of the road. They might get a piece of furniture from a friend or a family member, and they're trying to get rid of it, and it might have bed bugs in it. So these people are getting, it's nothing to fault of their own. I'm not trying to say, you know, poor people have bed bugs because they're poor. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is the mistakes that you make when you can't afford to do a lot can cause you to have problems with not only bed bugs, but also cockroaches. So people will bring a piece of furniture, used bed or a used sofa or used recliner into their house, and it will have bed bugs in it. They'll get used clothes from Goodwill and different places like that, or from a friend or a family member. We'll give them some clothes, and there may be bed bugs in the clothes because it's very common to find bed bugs in your dressers and your chest of drawers and places in your bedroom because it's where you sleep, it's where bed bugs live. So when you get these used clothes and you bring them into your home, you end up having bed bugs in your home. So then you go and you stay at a hotel, and they may be in your luggage. You know, you keep your luggage in your closets or whatever, and the bed bugs get into your luggage. And then you go and you, because, you know, even though people don't, you know, they may not have a lot of money, they still try to save their money to go on like a vacation. Sometimes they get a vacation every year, sometimes every other year, but everybody likes to get away sometimes. It doesn't matter how much money you make. Everybody needs a vacation at some point in their life. So they go out and they travel and they take the bed bugs on their luggage and they take them into these places, you know, these hotels, cheap hotels, because they can't afford a whole lot. You know, that's what you got to understand, is they cannot afford to stay at a higher end hotel. They also, a lot of them can't afford to get rid of the bed bugs on their own. You may be one of these people. I mean, the reason I started my channel was to help people like, you know, poorer people. I'm here to help you get rid of your bed bugs so you don't have to spend thousands of dollars on an exterminator. I have links below to products that I use personally that I recommend to use for bed bugs. If you cannot afford an exterminator, then by all means, follow my links and go and read about them. I have blogs I've written on my website about bed bugs and how to get rid of them, and go and read that stuff and educate yourself, and you will be able to get rid of bed bugs. You don't have to hire an exterminator to eliminate your bed bug problems, but that's what we're talking about. Okay, that's what I'm talking about here. That's what we're going on about why hotels get bed bugs. So person that can't afford to eliminate bed bugs, maybe they can't afford an extra $30 or $40 on a hotel room a night. So they go and they stay at a Motel 6, or they stay at a Super 8, or they stay at these, you know, no-tell motels that don't even have a name brand attached to them. It's just some guy in a small town owns a hotel, and there may be 12 rooms that he rents out for $30, $40 a night. All right, these hotel chains, they charge $30 or $40 a night. They can't afford a bed bug treatment either. Not a quality bed bug treatment. So they end up getting bed bugs. Their exterminator will get rid of their bed bugs. They'll try to get rid of their bed bugs and they'll spray for their bed bugs, but they may not be able to get rid of their bed bugs because the place isn't paying what it actually costs to get rid of bed bugs. So the bed bugs grow in these locations, these certain hotel chains. They get these bed bug problems. And so you've got to understand that those hotels, while they have bed bugs, they keep bed bugs. They don't get rid of their bed bugs. If you're willing to spend an extra $20 a night, $30 a night, the hotel, because they're renting at a higher rate, they're keeping their vacancies. They don't have vacancies. It's no vacancy because they've got quality rooms that they're renting. You up the scale of what you can afford. If you cannot afford a higher end hotel room to stay in, you absolutely can't afford to eliminate bed bugs. You may need to save up for a little while longer. So what hotels have I stayed in that I have found bed bugs? I have found bed bugs in Holiday Inns. I have found them in Motel 6s. I have found them in Super 8s. I have not found a single bed bug infestation in Embassy Suites. I have not found them in a Hilton. I've stayed at several Hiltons. I've stayed at Embassy Suites. I've stayed at your higher end Marriott's. I have not found bed bugs. Now, there are some people who have commented on some of my videos, and I'm sure you will comment below. There have been a few people that claim that Marriott's and stuff have bed bugs. I have never found bed bugs in a Marriott, and I'm not being paid by these hotel chains by any means, but I have never found a bed bug in an Embassy Suites. And really, when you compare the prices on like Priceline or Expedia or Hotels.com, you're really only complaining about maybe an extra $20 or $30 a night. It's not a lot of money. Do you know how much bed bugs cost to get rid of? They cost hundreds of dollars. They cost thousands of dollars. The cheapest price that I have gotten as far as a quote for bed bug elimination in Northern Virginia, in the, I believe it was either Chantilly or Sterling, was $4,900 to eliminate their bed bug infestation. For one visit, no guarantee, just one visit, $4,900. $4,900. The most expensive was out of Woodbridge, Virginia, which is about 20 to 30 minutes south of DC, and they wanted $12,000 on a one-time service for bed bugs. One-time service, $12,000. If you can't afford $20 a night in addition to what you're already paying, you absolutely cannot afford $12,000. Okay? That's a lot of money. And honestly, a bottle of Crossfire, a 13-ounce bottle of Crossfire, costs anywhere from $30 to $50, depending on, you know, if you can get it on sale or not. That's going to be the difference of your hotel room. So you're still going to pay the difference of the hotel room. If it's one night, you're still going to pay that fee in other means. So you're probably going to have to buy a bottle of Crossfire or a spray can or something like that to apply your pesticide. So you're still going to spend the money. It's better to just splurge a little bit and get your room at a higher rate. Now, these hotels, they give you things too. So it's not just a place to sleep. All right, so Embassy Suites, they do a thing where they have a cocktail night, and I think it's like from 5 to 7 at night, and you can go down and it's open bar, house liquor is free, and you can get like a margarita, or you can get, rum on the rocks or something. You know, you can get a drink, a mixed drink. You can get, they do a snack bar, so you can, at the same time, so you can go and you can get like some carrots and crackers and dips and chips and stuff like that for free. And they give you a full continental breakfast in the morning. So the type of food, I'm fat. I like to eat. You know, this is the thing about me. I like to eat. So in the mornings when I eat breakfast at Embassy Suites, they have things. Now, I am vegan, so I don't eat a lot of meat. But if you ever been at an Embassy Suites in the morning, they have sausage, bacon, ham. They do omelet bar. They have salads. They have all kinds of, like, fruit salad is what I meant by, you know, breakfast, fruit salads and stuff, oranges, apples, bananas, you know, they have that at every continental breakfast if you ever stay at many hotels. But they also do, you know, like I said, omelet bars, you can get scrambled eggs, you can get potato fries and stuff first thing in the morning when you first get up, hash browns and all kinds of stuff. And that, you know, if you go to like a restaurant or something and you try to pay for something like that, you're going to spend more than the cost of your room. And you can get it right there at the hotel when you first get up in the morning. You can have yourself a nice, good, big breakfast and get your day started out right. So I feel like for the cost in, you know, and just for your sanity alone, it's worth the extra $20 or $30 a night to stay at somewhere like an Embassy Suites or a Hilton or, you know, a Marriott or somewhere that you're going to spend more. You know, you are going to spend more to stay there. But the point is that you're going to spend less overall. It is more affordable to spend a little more money in your hotel room to not have bed bugs. If you've ever had bed bugs before, you understand the stress that comes with a bed bug infestation. You feel like you can't visit your friends. You feel like you can't visit your family. You feel like you can't even have them in your house because you're worried they're going to pick up bed bugs from your house. You can't have this problem exist in your home again, and it kind of ruins vacations. So hopefully this video has helped you to a little bit, you know, at least in your stress level, that you can stay at a hotel and not get bed bugs. And if you ever do get into a room, all right, you go to your room. This is a piece of advice I have to give everyone. I have to give everyone this specific piece of advice. It will help you so much with bed bugs in hotels. If you decide to stay in a no-tell motel or a really cheap hotel overnight, $30, $40, $50 a night, if you decide to stay at one of these places and you're wanting to try to, you know, eliminate your bed bugs, it's to save money, stay at a cheap hotel, but not bring bed bugs home because you're more likely to get bed bugs from these cheaper hotels. You're wanting to eliminate that. You're wanting to reduce that, you know, problem. Then what you do is you go into the hotel. You take an extra 20 or 30 minutes to check in. Get your key. Go up to the room. Check your beds. If you have to flip your bed upside down and tear the sheets off the mattress, do it. You are allowed to do it. It is your money. You are spending your money to stay in this hotel. Check around the box spring. Check the springs. Check the mattress. Check the headboard itself. A lot of times the headboard is actually screwed to the wall. Look around behind the headboard where it actually attaches to the wall. And make sure that there aren't any bed bugs living on the headboard. This is a place that's overlooked a lot in hotels, that I have found bed bugs living on the headboard. This is places that I have treated and stayed at where I have found bed bugs living on the headboard. So be sure to check those areas. They get overlooked a lot by cleaning crew. And so it's a way that you can tell if there's bed bugs in a room or not. Check underneath your mattress where the seams are on the mattress. Check underneath the box spring. You know, look around all the staples. You can't open it up like it were at your own house because it's, you know, someone else's bed. But if you check around all the seams and the folds and the pleats of where the fabric actually pleats together. I stayed one time at a hotel, and I'm not going to say which one, in West Virginia. I was doing a bed bug job in Winchester. And so I stayed overnight. The only hotel they had open was in West Virginia, about 20 minutes away. And so I stayed in West Virginia at a hotel. And I went into the room. I checked around the pleats of the mattress and the box spring. And when I pulled back the little fold inside the pleats on the box spring, I found a bed bug nestled inside that pleat. So the bed didn't look like it had bed bugs on it at all, but for sure there was one inside those pleats. The maids have learned, you know, maid service in your hotel chains, they have learned ways to be able to clean up, to hide a bed bug infestation. So they're taught this, they are trained on this, on how to keep customers from being able to know they have a bed bug problem. So you have to be very, it's almost like being an investigator, like you're some kind of an FBI agent or somebody like that. You know, you're going in and you're trying to find the evidence. So you need to really go over the room with a fine-tooth comb. It may take you 20 or 30 minutes to check the room over really well before you decide, yes, this is a place I'm going to stay. If you find bed bugs, that doesn't mean that the entire hotel has bed bugs. It could just mean that someone came in that room the night before, left bed bugs behind, and now there's a bed bug problem in that room. So what do? You go down to the desk and you tell the lady, you say, look, I need a different room. This room has bed bugs. It's infested. I'm not taking bed bugs home with me. You need to find me another room. And if they don't have another room available, say, well, then give me a refund. I am going to find another room. even if it's 9 o'clock at night, you know, you might have just arrived there late night and you're like, I really don't want to go anywhere else and go through this whole thing, this rigmarole of checking another bed in another location. But if they're not going to work with you and they're not going to give you back, give you a different room, then you say, fine, you're going to give me a refund. Because they're required to give you a refund. You say, fine, you're going to give me a refund. If you're not going to give me a refund, I'll call my lawyer and I'll have my lawyer sue you tomorrow because I'm not staying in a room with bedbugs. I'm not going to take bedbugs home. Take control of the situation. Don't let a hotel control you over a bedbug infestation. You are allowed to see the room. You are allowed to reject the room. You are allowed to get your refund. Because they've tried to rent you a room with bedbugs. And you'll find that when you behave this way, a lot of times a no vacancy hotel, which is what I was dealing with in West Virginia, the no vacancies became, oh, all of a sudden they had a room to put me in. They didn't want to give me back a refund. They didn't want to hear from a lawyer. They found another room that, you know, apparently a room that they didn't have came available. So they gave me another room. I stayed overnight at the same hotel. I took 20 minutes. I went over that room too, and I checked it. And I actually, one time, I had a room that I went to in Virginia Beach. I had a job in Virginia Beach. It was a hotel in Virginia Beach. And it was supposed to be a pet-friendly hotel. I had a dog at the time. Took a dog with me. Found out the hotel's not pet-friendly. So we ended up having to go to a different hotel. Spur, on the moment, ran to a second hotel. When we got to the second hotel, I went into the room. The bed was infested. I mean, it wasn't just a mild infestation. It was heavily infested with bed bugs. It was really, really severe. When I went down to the front desk to get my refund, I told the guy, I said, look, you're going to have to give me my money back. Don't charge that card because that room's infested with bed bugs. He looked at me with the most solemn expression and said, you didn't tear those beds up, did you? Because I've got to send a maid up there to remake that bed tonight so someone can rent that room. And I said, you ought not rent that room. It's infested with bed bugs. You need to kill your bed bugs. Don't rent a room that's infested with bed bugs to people. So I got my refund. I left and went to a different hotel. Again, a third hotel. So I'd been to two already and had to go to a third. So understand, you might have to do that before you find a room that's worth staying in. So this is what you're running into if you're wanting to save money. So understand that if you're wanting to save money, you're gonna work for it. It's a job. You know, it might be worth it to you to not have to go to hotel after hotel after hotel after hotel trying to find one that doesn't have bed bugs to save $20 or $30 on your vacation. You gotta realize this is a vacation. You're trying to spend time with your family, with your friends. And is it really worth it to travel to hotel to hotel to hotel in hopes that you can find one without bed bugs? No, I don't think so. So hopefully this video has helped you. I know I rambled a lot, but it was a lot to say. I really want to help people. I don't find bed bugs in hotels anymore. I don't think the trouble is as bad, but like I said, I do spend an extra $20 or $30 to stay overnight. And it's just one night. I know it can get really expensive. If you're spending like a week in Myrtle Beach or something like that, you might spend, you know, several hundred dollars more. But it's still cheaper than $4,900 or $12,000. You know, you may have to eat out less. Try to find yourself an economy room with a kitchen. So you might be able to eat in maybe one night or two to save the money that you need, that you would normally have to spend on, you know, eating out at a restaurant or something like that. So hopefully this has helped. You guys have a really great day. I really appreciate it. Like I said, like, thumb up the video if you really liked it. If you made it all the way to the end of the video, 25 minutes long, boring video of me rambling, tell me below. Let me know if you made it to the end. I really appreciate you guys. I've got the best YouTube audience ever. I look forward to talking to you guys Thursday nights live. And like I said, subscribe to my channel so you don't miss any more videos like this. You guys have a really great time. I really appreciate it. And I'll be seeing you later. Thanks.